Tom.
Hello, internet. This is a short video before I depart about something like you can see. That's a TFL leaflet, how to use the bus. Help the driver, you can read it for yourself. Closing the doors is the most important. If you're waiting to board on the bus and doors close, please wait for the next bus. Don't distract the driver as they will need to leave the stop safely. So that's the most important one, as you can see. So that's why on my other videos, that's how I acted, and that's why it's my decision to terminate the bus and stuff like that. And you can see the other ones. It's on all the bus stops. But anyway, now it's time to depart.
Okay.
Yeah, let's go.
And you guys upload it on YouTube?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, I have a channel about uploading stuff that happens to me some days. Oh, there is one more person. And you know, just explaining the how to use the buses properly, not to argue with the drivers and stuff like that.
Yeah, okay.
Hello, sir.
You're right.
Yes. We are departing, just waiting for you now.
Okay, thank you very much.
Let's go. So, yeah, guys, we are now just starting our day. Today we are going to Golders Green. And it's 2:30. The schools are just finishing, some of them. So hopefully it's not too crazy on the road. But you never know. Okay, thank you. And in the comments there is some people that are saying that TFL have to put some leaflets and things like that explaining about the rules on the buses, but they don't have to put to give any leaflets to the people, because all those rules, they are on the bus stops. All the rules are on the bus stops. So there is no need to waste paper and money about leaflets when they have bus stops, and they have tens of thousands of bus stops actually. And all of those tens of thousands of bus stops, you can find relative information to how to use the buses, even inside the bus as well. So yeah, that's a TFL rule. If the doors close on you, don't knock on the doors, don't interrupt the driver, wait for the next bus. Simple. Enjoy the trip. I won't be talking anymore for this video. Well, unless something happens. Hopefully nothing happens. So just enjoy the trip. Oh, you're welcome. You finished?
No, I'm gonna run for that place. Yeah, I finished. So I'm running for that place.
No, well, good luck. Apologize about the squeaky steering wheel. It's very, very squeaky for some reason on this bus, so you'll have to endure that. And also this video is a little bit higher resolution, so let's see if it looks better on YouTube. I also plan to go around London and see the different bus stops, if they have different rules, different notices about how to use the buses on the different bus stops around London, and I will film them and make a video about them. So hopefully people will know how to use the bus, because if you start knocking on the door and arguing with the driver that he closed the door and he didn't open it again and things like that, then obviously that's not how you use the bus. If you start arguing and knocking on the door and using the emergency button to enter the bus, then you're using the bus wrong. So if you're using the bus wrong, in the wrong way, then obviously it's not the driver's fault that you're using it wrong and you have not read what's on those notices on the bus stops on how to use the bus. That's on you, not reading. You've been on that bus stop for hours every month. You have no excuse not to read 10 lines of text. Okay, everyone. No, you need 140. 140.
Thank you. go to screen. The driver has been told to wait at this bus stop for a short time to help even out the service. We apologize for any inconvenience to your journey.
Now, hello, we're gonna stay here for 3 minutes. Our departure time is 15:06. Departure time is 15:06. We're waiting here for 3 minutes. Those of you that don't know, you can wait maximum, this bus can stay a maximum for 3 minutes at a bus stop, and after 3 minutes you have to either terminate the service or depart. So that's what the bus drivers can use if they want to get somebody out of the bus. After 3 minutes, just stay on the bus stop. After, if that person have not left the bus or the problem have not been resolved, after 3 minutes you have to terminate or depart. And if there is problem on board, you cannot depart, so you have to terminate. Those are the rules. And when you terminate the bus, then you can, people are obviously not allowed to be and a bus that is not on service. When you are not in service, you are not allowed to have passengers, and they are not allowed to be on board as well. If they refuse to leave or do some stupid shit, just call the police so they can get them out of the bus. It's that simple. And those buses, they're not public property. They are actually private property. So when the bus is not in service, they are actually trespassing. And if you are trespassing and you are asked to leave and you refuse to leave, well, obviously then things can be very easily escalated by the police. All the bus drivers, there is no need to leave the bus cabin or to argue with people. Just tell them, and if that person wants to be to show his true colors, that he is antisocial, just make sure you make announcement sounding something like, "Hello, ladies and gentlemen." Tell them about the issue, like there is a person on board that is getting alcohol, smoking cigarettes, or press the emergency button to enter the bus or whatever. Whatever the issue is, tell them that. After this, following that, we will stay on this bus stop for 3 minutes. If this person doesn't leave by then, the whole service will be terminated here. And all of you will have to leave the bus. So just tell them that. And if that person doesn't leave, obviously just terminate the whole service. Because as you know, buses don't discriminate, they only terminate.
Please stay with your luggage for your child's sake.
this place in Kingsbury, that yellow box, there is a camera. They put the very juicy finds very often. So don't stay inside the yellow box, guys. If you cannot fit your bus, stop. If you have to stay here 10 minutes and make a huge traffic jam, stop and stay. Me personally, I just stay there and wait for all the cars that are turning or whatever they are doing. So I am 100% sure that I am not caught inside that yellow box. And as you know, as a bus driver, you're paid to stay in traffic. That's why they pay you, to stay in traffic. So the more traffic it is, the more you stay, the more money you get. So yeah, just stay and chill. Oh dear, I love that car. It's parked in the best way, sideways. And that's a disabled as well. Okay, it's not disabled bay. It's a normal bay. And this whole area here is like 10-15 miles per hour. Like I usually go with 10, maximum 15 if I feel brave. If I'm in a hurry. Yeah, it's 10 miles per hour. There is speed bumps, pedestrians, cars, opening doors and parking, everything. Bye-bye. carbs here, you'll notice that they're lowered, all of them. So pedestrians and also so buses don't have to climb that much on them, which we usually do, unfortunately. It's a very tight turn. You can do it easily. Sometimes you just end up going over the curb. Sometimes on these buses you have to press the raise button to raise the bus because, I don't know, when people come on it gets lower so the door cannot close when the ramp is extended. Every single bus stop, or almost every single bus stop, there is a bin, rubbish bin for the rubbish. So when people leave the bus, they can dispose of their rubbish there as they leave the bus. But people are too lazy, so they just leave the rubbish on the bus while the bin is right outside of the bus. So yeah, it's just people being people. That's why the bus have so much rubbish in them, because of the lazy people. Every single bus stop you go, they have bins for that reason. So people have where to dispose of the rubbish. Instead of leaving it inside the bus. You can see the bins here. Almost all of them. Like, probably, if I have to say, it's gonna be 98% of the bus stops. Between 98 and 95% of them have rubbish bins. So people have no excuse to leave their rubbish on the bus, but they do. TfL have put a lot of effort designing everything to be properly done and to be useful in a meaningful way. It's just the users, in the users' fault, the, meaning the people that are supposed to be using it, they just use it wrong, just as they use the bus wrong. When they knock on the door and think like that when the door is closed.
support from NF2 to the mobiles affected by Putney High Street, just with Upper Richmond Road. This road is now open. It was under NOE 0-2-4-5-0-2-6-6-8-Alpha. I'll repeat, 0-2-4-5-0-2-6-6-Alpha. This road is now open. All routes back to line of route, please. That'll be routes 14-39-74-85-93-170-430 and the S10 board, please. All lines on route. Controllers, FYI, 0-2-4-5-0-2-6-6-8-Alpha. Many thanks,
NFTCM. So for the bus heating, you have a couple of options. You always, if it's very cold outside, keep it recirculating. If it's not cold, keep it fresh. Keep it on fresh air, so you don't end up with steamy bus. And the controls, I don't know who designed the whole climate control on those buses. It's designed very badly. The whole programming, it's done wrong. Like, it doesn't make any sense. It doesn't work properly as it's supposed to. Like, if you put it on window, okay, that's for demisting. If you put it on feet, that's for heating. If you put it on both, it doesn't heat up at all. So you have to put it on feet if you want to have any warmth, any heat. And the other important bit, if you put it on auto, then the heating is gonna work with combination for demisting on the window. But if it's not on auto, then the whole club, it doesn't heat up anything. So you have to choose between staying warm and being able to see through the window, which is retarded design. So whoever designed them, the whole programming is incompetent and have not tried how it works actually. It's literally a choice. Literally a choice between staying warm and being able to see through the window. Like, it's the worst design for a temperature controls, and that's how they did it. Now it's time for our first set of temporary traffic lights. Nobody goes around it. So yeah, the whole junction there gets blocked. They will now have green light, but they can't go on green because the bus is here. So yeah, whoever designed this whole thing here, look, they have green. Maybe they can squeeze. Maybe. Okay, good job. Okay, let's mark that guy, no ticket. I just marked him 2 times. Just because. Just because. Maybe some of my colleagues forget to mark the previous ones without the ticket, so I'm doing an extra one for my colleagues. Or somebody hit or car crash. Okay, we can actually, when the lorry goes through, time track. Okay, we're good now. Please wait and don't go there. Hurry, but the traffic is not moving, so don't go like that in front of the bus. Thank you. over here. It's two lanes, only from here until the traffic light. After this, it merges again, so that there is no point to go. And just treat this one lane. Okay, we are not going. We could have gone, but it's the Northern Circular, which is main road. So try not to block main roads. Steaming, we'll see now when I get the Baldur's Green upstairs how it looks, and downstairs if the windows are steaming, because they always get steamy when it's raining. But if you put it on fresh air, which now it's on fresh air, supposedly all the moisture from the people is going outside. And yeah, it's raining, but the moisture from the people, the air is more moist inside the bus than it's outside. So by keeping it on fresh air, that helps with the steamy windows of the bus. Okay. Thank you for watching, guys. Have a nice day.